Matter of fact, let's just make this simple and plain. I grab this, they won't remember his name. He'll be past tense. He'll literally go from Av to memory lane. First.
You forgot about the little Noane. That thing be going crazy. And since Charlie bit me, there's one finger on the bait.
Y'all might have to play this back, but when you piece it all together, those are the type of lines that created smack. So
batter up is often compared to pro wrestling, and for good reason. The promo. The blurred line between the real and the fabricated, the larger-than-life personas, and the crowd engagement are a few things that come to mind. One of the most distinguishable things about each character is their moveset. Batter Up emulates this aspect of wrestling wholeheartedly. In today's episode of Batter Up Tactics, we're taking a look at one aspect of the game that many battlers use to one-up their opponent. Special moves. While you can argue how effective signature moves have been in the sport, you can't argue how prevalent it has been in the last 12 years or so. There are 7 special moves I want to highlight and describe the purpose and intent behind each one. I do want to express that there is a difference between having a slogan and a signature move. Are they associated with one another? Absolutely. They also can operate as one, but in order for the slogan to be considered a signature move, in this sense, it has to be weaponized in a battle rap form. A prime example of this is DNA's slogan, GTFOH, and I'm not going to say it out loud. There are instances where he uses this to form a haymaker. He's either restructuring the lyrics for his opponent, calling out another opponent, or making it applicable to the environment or circumstance. This typically goes over well when DNA just delivered an incredible round prior to the slogan.
It's round one, it's getting hot in here, and what's the whole guy know my slogan? Get Ness the fuck out of here. Every time I battle Philly rappers, I chill them. I got Noane Tech the fuck out of here. In that third round, I got my tooth the fuck out of here. Fuck every legend on the card. Get Iron Rex Luxurious and move the fuck out of here.
The slogan can also operate as an alert to the crowd. A huge part of crowd control is having the ability to redirect the audience and make them focus on a particular sequence of your lyrics. The first prominent example of this has garnered a humongous crowd reaction across the entire world. Showtime. A-Verb is a momentum rapper, meaning that he has to build to a certain spot and relies heavily on rhythm, syllabics, and pace. The Showtime enables him to accentuate his rapping ability while also capturing momentum in his raps. It makes for an extensive highlight reel.
So it's
showtime! I ride up on this nigga while he's chilling on the weekend, creeping, seat back, iron low, like I'm anemic. I'm a wet I'm a wet everybody out here. Cannonball off the deep end, extensions. Nina, let me put my bitch weave in. One chance.
So it's
showtime!
Let's get into that verb shit, that wordsmith, this gift that I was cursed with, that flip a bird shit, ride up, reverse it, shirts get rang out, that's a purchase, do a nigga greasy for that chicken, that's churches, long range shooter,
red on them like a stock exchange, directions read lots of pain, picture, open heart like a locket chain, I've been watching Bane, ride up, rockets bang from a proper range, he terrified, swerving, spinning the wheel like he Doctor Strange, I'm not for game.
War is raw, nigga. It's needed. I'm dyslexic. It look wrong to y'all, but not how I see it. Listen, next.
New Jersey Twerk established his own signature move early, and probably by accident. Twerk's signature could be a wild card because it can either be performative, an extremely layered bar, or both. Either way, the crowd anticipates this segment of the battle, and it could be the most electrifying moment of the night.
I'll clap you in a coma! Madness! My pin just better. I did the salsa. That was Big Beretta. Grew up, had a 15 to her. She had a quinceañera. I let her know. I'm strapped in. body in a coma. Madness, I can snap it anymore.
Pull a pound, honey clip, he get the fully round. Hell no, who did it? I'm over the body with the hoodie down. Show you how to really do it. I'm strapped in. I clap you in a coma.
Madness, I can snap it anymore.
You always fucking joking. You might just die. You can't wake up by the casket and say psych out loud.
I can snap it anymore.
I'm a live wire too. Now I might shoot. You think I'm less of a Christian because I'm not a Christian battler? I'm going to slide right through. Of course, I still walk by faith. And sometimes I drive by too.
Shotgun Shug is one of the most performative battlers in battle rap. He also has one of the most performative special moves in battle rap. And this is none other than the pocket tap. Simple but effective. I liken this move to the RKO because it can literally come out of nowhere.
He ain't no boss on the block. He's a stunt dummy. Like you know, roll his blunt for me. Big Brody don't pay for nothing. I take this nigga lunch money. The let shit slide, nigga. You too big. Have some pride, nigga. I said I would, man, say I lied, nigga. I'm lawyered up. Fell back for Hitman, cause you know, them MTV niggas be lawyered up. But I'll fuck you up, and your friends too. Dems do. I got my second half now, and his too.
This motherfucker got me pissed off. He talking about he letting his rocket off. He cotton soft. God damn, I forgot to rip his pockets off.
I let three of them clap. Let me get out the way now, Mr. Simpson.
There are very few times that a prop can be immensely impactful in the culture. In wrestling, it is when Mankind pulls out the sock. But in battle rap, it is when Daylight puts on the ski mask and gets into action. While Daylight's career is littered with antics, mystique, and blatant nonsense, the mask itself makes for some amazing moments.
All you can try to stop these uppercuts from changing colors, or you can die. And you see that I'm the realer, nigga? Why? Fuck that mask. I want you to look your killer in the eyes. If I chase a nigga, block break a nigga, funeral homes, box wake a nigga, you get the open hand, the fist, or the deuce. Rock, paper, scissors. First of all, don't hype his pride. To kill you, I was searching for the right disguise. So fuck this mask, I want you to look your killer in the eyes. Psych, I lied.
Most top tiers claim that if you don't have a special move, then you aren't a top tier. And the superstar who is well known in reaffirming this stance is none other than Soundz. While he has had a plethora of patented moves in his arsenal, the lockpick is the most distinguishable. This is because it is only used on special occasions, and has been effective more often than not.
The chamber got one, and the clip got Aiden. Michael Myers jumping with the mask off of Jason. Lockpick is door. Stick my face in the Terminator mode, like the baby out the playpen. Lockpick his door. I was about to let it ring, but I didn't want to hit his mother with a rocket, yeah, man. So I said, ass back, cut down the hall. Safety don't let it fly, he get in the mall. I push the door open, he was sitting in his jaws before he could say, what the? Knock his head through the wall.
Shells in his block clip. Queen Latifah set it off mass. Jump in the 380. Cops catch him, fuck it. It was ugly, he could plead crazy. Lockpick the door. They sleep, baby, see it, something, bye. G baby. Jumping around pacing, it was a Michael Myers jumping in the mask off of Jack. Lockpick the door. Stick my face in. That was 12 years ago. How the fuck I'm still amazing? For 10 plus years I've been.
Last but not least, we have a cheat code that I don't think many others can pull off. The remix. Once again, simple but effective. On the surface, repeating a line over and over again may seem redundant and impractical. but when you're one of the best performers in the world, it just amplifies the haymaker you deliver.
God, that Mac 5 will put him in the earth like a bad vibe. That Mac 5 will put him in the earth like a bad vibe. Bring him back, point blank range and knock the brains out of him. Then reload with the bullets that came. Then reload with the bullets that came out of him. As soon as I lift that, watch a nigga load it. Soon as I lift that, watch a nigga load it. That bitch go kaboom. That bitch go kaboom. That bitch go kaboom.
Down the motherfucker.
We ain't had to do all that for these bitches. So it's
showtime.
Wait, let me read it. Crosswalk.
What up?
Kaleidoscope vision. I can see up the lot of vision. I can see up the 9 blocks.
What else?
100 round drum. I can wake up 100 round drum. I can wake up like 9
blocks. And I'll be hanging out the window with.
No, bird, that's my.
Thank you guys for watching, and I hope you guys enjoyed the video. What are some of your special moves you guys enjoy in the culture? Comment below and subscribe to the channel.